Jess, first day of racing, how did it go for you?
It went well. It was a qualification run for C1, and I just decided to do my first run, and I put down a solid run, a little mistake in the middle section, but it was enough for second place, and I'm through to the semis, so that's the job done for the day, and I can focus on the K1 tomorrow.
Yeah. Hey, one of the things I'm curious for, you've trained here a lot, but did you discover some new things doing a race that were different from, well, having trained so far?
Not really. I think, you know, we've been here for 2 weeks now, and I came in July as well, so I feel like I know the course quite well. I think when it's race day, for me, it's easier to put together a full-length run, and in training sometimes you feel like you get carried away a bit more and distracted, but for racing I find that, you know, this was a challenging course, quite open on the top section and the hard moves on the bottom, so it was good to get out there and have a run in C1 so that I'm better prepared for K1 tomorrow.
Yeah. Well, one of the things I notice is, you know, I've seen the training sessions and it's so busy, you know, everyone is pedaling, too many people on the course, whereas in the competition you have all the space to do your own thing. Is that correct? Or?
That's right. I think it definitely in training it gets pretty busy. Everybody's trying to do different things, and sometimes it's hard to put down a run without somebody getting in the way. So being by yourself out on the course is quite nice, and just having, you know, you and the water and the gates and hearing the crowd and your teammates cheering you on is quite nice as well. So I'm really looking forward to the rest of the weekend.
Yeah. Hey, well, we've already discussed this before, but what do you think makes this course a bit challenging or difficult or maybe even annoying to a certain extent? I don't know, but
I think you have to keep the boat quite flat, because it's easy for the water to push you around and the back of the boat and to get unstable. Or at least that's how I feel on this course. So I've kind of learned to be more relaxed on this water and not get too carried away and too rushed, because that's when sometimes you could get pushed around and that's when, you know, the mistakes happen.
I was sitting on the other side of the course, and then I heard on this side you slipped or something. You lost your tee grip.
I think, yeah, I made a mistake in that run. I kind of lost my balance and let go of my tee grip and actually used my hand as a support stroke to not fall in. And so I lost a little bit of time there, but still managed to have quite a fast time. And I think, you know, the girls are all quite close to that time that I put out in that run. So the level's definitely improved, and it's only the heats, you know, sometimes that's when people hold back a little bit. Yeah. or they're a bit nervous, and, you know, you build through the race. So I'm, you know, definitely not letting my guard down. I know that there's some really strong competitors in the C1 women field.
All right. Hey, well, that was definitely not the last question, because I'm so curious.
Okay.
You have a plan of attack for the C1, and then you do your K1. Are those two different plans, or are they more or less intertwined? Are they separate? Well, how does that work?
They used to be very different, and now I've kind of tried to make them quite similar to each other, because I think what works well for me in C1 should be able to work well for me in K1. So I'm kind of taking a different approach to the way I'm paddling K1 to try and just feel the water a bit more and kick in the speed when I feel relaxed and in control of the boat. So I think having done C1 last year and K1 last year, I know what to expect at this World Championships, and I'm looking forward to racing.
Okay, sounds good. Thank you, Jess.
Thank you.